Tonight on NewsWatch, the gun control debate takes center stage. The latest on White House meetings.
Plus, the child porn sting that put hundreds of people across the world behind bars.
And why there's hope for thousands of orphans growing up without parents and separated from their culture. All this and more tonight on NewsWatch. It's a debate that's drawn much attention after the tragic shootings like Aurora, Colorado and Newtown, Connecticut. Good evening. I'm Mark Martin.
And I'm Wendy Griffith. Tomorrow, the top group opposing most gun control and President Obama's point man to come up with more gun control face off. But before that White House meeting today, Vice President Joe Biden was talking with those who've actually faced some of the worst consequences of recent mass shootings. Paul Strand reports from the White House.
Vice President Biden met with survivors of mass shootings and relatives of victims who died in such massacres and spoke of the Newtown, Connecticut tragedy.
I don't think anything has touched the heart of the American people so profoundly as seeing those learning of those young children not only being shot but riddled with bullets.
We have to have a broader discussion of this issue and discuss what we can do to prevent the 10,000 murders that happen every year, the 30,000 gun deaths every year.
President Obama has tasked Biden with giving him gun control proposals by the end of January for both Congress and the White House to consider. Biden promised White House action, even some without Congress's say-so.
The president is going to act. There are executive orders, executive action that can be taken. We haven't decided what that is yet.
Whatever such moves might be, they'll likely upset Obama opponents, already angered by the hundreds of regulations and executive orders his administration has come up with, free of any input from Congress. But there are also laws the White House wants Congress to pass to tighten the control of guns.
The president has already called on Congress to act on an assault weapons ban, to act on a ban of high-capacity ammunition clips.
Top Senate Republican Mitch McConnell has already weighed in on that, saying all the battling over budgets, debt limits, and the like will forestall any action Congress can take on gun control for at least 3 months. Next up, a Thursday White House meeting where Biden will talk with gun owner groups such as the National Rifle Association.
We're reaching out to all parties on whatever side of this debate you fall.
The NRA is likely to be the most powerful opponent of any White House moves gun owners see as a threat to their liberty and their Second Amendment rights. Paul Strand, CBN News, Washington.
Nearly 250 men and women are now behind bars. They were arrested in a major crackdown on international child pornography. Two of those arrests were made less than 24 hours after agents released the suspects' photos in the media. Ephraim Graham reports.
52-year-old Letha Mae Montemayor and 43-year-old Lance Robert Fries are the latest suspects arrested in Operation Sunflower, a U.S. Immigration and Customs Enforcement sting to identify and rescue victims of child pornography. Montemayor faced a judge in a California court Tuesday. Investigators say their five-week sting exposed her in photos with children as long as 11 years ago.
The results were significant but grim. And demands, absolutely demands, our full attention as a nation.
ICE agents say the internet has made child pornography a growing international business. It's now also being streamed live worldwide. And the criminals aren't often strangers to their young victims.
When we found 44 of our victims, they were living with the very person who was sexually abusing them.
Their unit identified and rescued 123 child victims. 110 were in the U.S., 46 were younger than 12, and 5 were under the age of 3.
It's a serious problem. It's a problem that we somehow have to get our hands around because it's not getting any better.
Special Agent John Callahan says child pornography is one of the fastest growing crimes in America. In fact, there's been a 2,500% increase in arrests in 10 years. The National Center for Missing and Exploited Children reviewed more than 10.5 million images of child porn in 2009 alone. And investigators note, a serial child molester could have as many as 400 victims in his lifetime. Ephraim Graham, CBN News.
Part of Obamacare has been quietly repealed. It happened as part of the fiscal cliff deal. Congress overturned what's called the CLASS Act. It was basically a new entitlement program for long-term care. But the Heritage Foundation reports the program was so poorly designed that one of its own administrators warned Congress in 2011 that the program could collapse. Meanwhile, five new taxes instituted by Obamacare will kick in this year. One is called the medical device tax. It's a tax on everything from stents to syringes. A group of liberal senators, including Al Franken and John Kerry, had asked Senate Majority Leader Harry Reid to delay the tax because it's expected to raise health care costs. Last year, the Supreme Court ruled that Obamacare is constitutional, but the health care measure is facing a growing number of legal challenges. The one gaining the most steam is over the law's contraception mandate. Religious business owners and faith-based organizations argue the mandate violates their religious beliefs by forcing them to cover the morning-after pill and similar drugs in their insurance plans. Jay Sekulow of the American Center for Law and Justice said on today's 700 Club that this case is one that will ultimately be decided by the Supreme Court.
The idea that the government would put something in place that mandates or requires that you violate your conscience would make the founders to spin their heads. They wouldn't believe that the government would come in and demand you violate your sincerely held religious beliefs. So the claim is both on the Constitution and their statutory claims as well.
And to see that full interview with Jay, you can go to our website, cbnnews.com.
The National Cathedral in Washington will soon begin performing same-sex marriages. The 106-year-old cathedral has served as the spiritual center for the nation's capital. It's been the site of memorial services after national tragedies and funerals for Presidents Ronald Reagan and Gerald Ford. Now the church will be among the first Episcopal congregations to implement a new rite of marriage for gay, lesbian, bisexual, and transgender members. While many Christians disagree with gay marriage, the church's dean says embracing gay marriage is, quote, being faithful to the kind of community that Jesus would have us be.
And the widow of slain civil rights leader Medgar Evers and evangelical pastor Louis Giglio are scheduled to pray at President Obama's inauguration. Merle Evers Williams will pray the invocation at the ceremony. Evers Williams fought for justice 30 years after her husband was gunned down in his driveway in 1963. Reverend Louis Giglio of Atlanta's Passion Church will deliver the benediction at the end of the public ceremony. Giglio hosts the annual New Year's Passion Conference and is an advocate for ending modern-day slavery. The president says the two represent the ideals of justice, equality, and opportunity that he pursues.
What if you woke up one day and found that none of your electronics worked? Experts warn that Iran is working on a weapon that could wipe out our electronic systems and knock America back into the 19th century. Eric Stackelbeck reports.
Pentagon estimates show that by the year 2015, Iran could have missiles capable of reaching the east coast of the United States. If the Iranians acquire a nuclear bomb, they might be able to cripple their great Satan even sooner through an electromagnetic pulse or EMP attack off America's coastline.
Within a year of an EMP event, at least two-thirds of the American population would perish from starvation, disease, and societal collapse. It's a high-tech means of killing people the old-fashioned way.
A nuclear weapon detonated above the U.S. would emit powerful electromagnetic pulses, frying America's electrical grid and shutting down necessities from cars to computers to airplanes and refrigerators. Iranian military handbooks point out the benefits of such an attack, and Russia, China, and North Korea also possess EMP technology. Dr. Peter Pry, a member of the Congressional EMP Commission, says America could plunge back into the 19th century with Katrina-like chaos nationwide.
A single nuclear weapon will cause the collapse of the electric power grid and all the critical infrastructures and other electronic systems across the entire continental United States and basically cause a permanent blackout.
surprise nightmare scenario shows Iran or its terrorist proxy Hezbollah parking an unmarked freighter off America's east coast or in the Gulf of Mexico. They would fire a nuclear-tipped scud above a city like New York, then immediately sink the freighter to destroy evidence of their handiwork.
Even if we were able to identify the scud by our radars, we wouldn't know who did it. You know, this is a way of keeping your fingerprints off.
Former CIA double agent Reza Khalili spent time as a member of Iran's Revolutionary Guards Corps. He says the Iranians have conducted missile tests off of ships in the Caspian Sea that are consistent with an EMP-style attack. We've disguised his face and voice for his safety.
They're going to get to Gulf of Mexico with ballistic missiles, and they can launch one at a moment's notice, and they wouldn't care about the repercussion.
Khalili's book, A Time to Betray, details Iran's rapidly advancing ballistic missile program.
They have obtained missiles from North Korea that can now target the capitals of Europe.
There are reports that Iran plans to establish missile bases in Venezuela, where it has a vast network. And an Iranian official recently threatened to send military ships to patrol America's Atlantic coast. Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News.
Obama administration officials say the U.S. may pull all of its troops out of Afghanistan after December 2014. That goes against the Pentagon's view that America may need thousands of troops there to deal with al-Qaeda and help strengthen Afghan forces. The U.S. now has 66,000 troops in Afghanistan. Some officials say between 3,000 and 15,000 may stay. Our war correspondent Chuck Holton was recently with troops on the ground there. He says many don't see a full withdrawal as a good idea.
Giving full control over to the Afghans right now would be kind of like giving your 12-year-old son the keys to your Ford F-250. He might be able to drive it, but it would be a scary ride. If Afghan forces need heavy artillery and that sort of thing, they still have to come to us.
The primary concern over a withdrawal is how to prevent Afghanistan from falling back into the chaos of the 1990s. Those problems led to the Taliban taking power and providing a network for Osama bin Laden and al-Qaeda.
Coming up, the battle to end censorship in China.
CBNNews.com. News you want, when you want, 24/7. Stay current with up-to-the-minute stories.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, New York.
I don't have to wait for my news anymore.
CBNNews.com, at your fingertips all day long.
I only watch the stories I want to see.
I find the story, I click on it, and boom, I'm there.
Embassy in Washington, Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News.
The source for your news, CBNNews.com.
It's probably something I've had for many years, and every year the PSA would be a little higher. I just kept kind of ignoring it. You know, one of those guy things. It'll go away. It'll go away. Finally, one day, Janet says, "You're going to the doctor." They did a blood test. My PSA was 14. I needed to get a second opinion, so we contacted Cancer Treatment Centers of America.
To find out more about Cancer Treatment Centers of America and our unique treatment options for complex and advanced stage cancer, go to cancercenter.com.
The really great thing is that you just go online, and if you have prostate or lung cancer or whatever, you can see what their survival rates are.
You can also check for participating insurance plans. Cancer Treatment Centers of America is different. You feel it the moment you call or walk into one of our hospitals. It's state-of-the-art medicine, unique treatment options, and a level of compassion that cannot be copied. Why? Our people. People who give you not only their expertise, but their humanity and the most thoughtful, well-organized, patient-centered care you'll find anywhere.
Cancer Treatment Centers of America go way beyond what normal hospitals do. I knew that they had the technology to take care of my cancer. It's a device called Calypso.
Calypso is GPS for the prostate. We're able to get four-dimensional, real-time tracking of prostate movement during radiation treatment.
It eliminates a lot of my side effects. It makes sense. It just makes sense. I own a deli. I'm back at work. My customers come in and say, "Gosh, you look good." And some of them say, "I look better now than I did before I left." I didn't expect to learn a lesson about how to treat people by being in a hospital. You can tell when somebody really cares.
Every minute counts when you're fighting complex or advanced stage cancer. So please call or visit cancercenter.com today. Appointments are available now. Cancer Treatment Centers of America. Care that never quits.
A federal judge has ruled a Texas school district can kick out one of its students after she objected to wearing an ID card with a tracking device. The more than 4,000 students at Jay High School and Jones Middle School in San Antonio are being forced to wear smart ID badges with a tracking chip. 15-year-old Andrea Hernandez refused to wear the device. She says wearing it would violate her religious beliefs. She believes the badge is the mark of the beast referred to in the Book of Revelation. U.S. District Judge Orlando Garcia rejected her religious argument. He thinks her reasons are secular. He ruled the school can expel her while the case is moving through the courts.
Signs of progress in the battle to end censorship in China. After days of protests, officials agreed to a tentative deal over press freedom. And in North Korea, two prominent Americans are pressing communist leaders to open internet access to its citizens. George Thomas has the details.
The freedom of press and freedom of speech.
This act of suppressing the freedom of the press should be changed.
One veteran foreign reporter based in Beijing said it is the first time since 1989 that Chinese journalists are saying no and striking against government censorship.
This is going to be detrimental to the public interest of knowing the facts.
Hundreds of staff, readers, and human rights activists have been protesting outside the Southern Weekly offices in Guangzhou, China. The controversy started New Year's Day when the Southern Weekly, a well-known liberal newspaper, was set to publish an article calling for the government to respect freedom and human rights. Under pressure, the editors replaced it with a story celebrating the government's achievements.
I'm here to say the Southern Weekly is not alone. There are lots of people supporting them.
Now the local government propaganda authority has reportedly made a deal to relax censorship controls over the newspaper. But staff and protesters are waiting to read the fine print of the agreement.
If we always have censorship and the media face shutdown every day, the media become the tool to cheat the people. Is there any hope for this country?
China is notorious for censoring the press and internet. More than 350 million people have access to the internet in China, but only a portion of the World Wide Web is available to online users. Meanwhile, in neighboring North Korea, Google's executive Eric Schmidt and former New Mexico Governor Bill Richardson spend the day visiting a computer lab in Pyongyang. The two are on a four-day trip to the communist nation, pressing the reclusive leaders there to, among other things, give people access to the internet and cell phones.
We've been meeting with a variety of foreign affairs officials, internet officials, scientists, political leaders.
George Thomas, CBN News.
Up next, how some orphanages are working to keep families together.
Listen up for an amazing offer that can change the way you hear.
I'm sorry, I didn't hear you. Can you repeat that?
Frustrated with your hearing?
What did he say?
Well, hear better now. Introducing the fully rechargeable MSA30X, a revolutionary device that features the latest microsound amplification technology that can barely be seen. Independently tested to help you hear up to 30 times better. It turns ordinary hearing into extraordinary hearing. MSA30X works by capturing and amplifying sound waves, yet its lightweight ergoacoustic design is discreet. It form fits in and around either ear.
I forget I'm even wearing it.
An MSA30X is powerful. Hear clearly in restaurants. Never miss another word on TV or at the movies.
My wife complains that I have the volume up on the TV too loud.
And I didn't want to be in the same room with them.
Now I can hear everything clearly.
Simply adjust the volume as you desire. Other units use so many batteries and they're difficult to change. But the MSA30X is completely rechargeable. Simply plug it into the wall.
I tried other devices that had batteries, but they were always such a pain to change and so costly. But this is rechargeable, so I figure I save hundreds a year.
Bulky sound amplifiers can cost hundreds, but try MSA30X for just $59.95 and we'll include a cleaning brush and five comfort tips. But wait, in this special TV offer, we'll cut the price in half. Now you can hear up to 30 times better for just $29.95. But there's even more. We'll double the offer free. Just pay additional processing and handling. Wear them both or give one to a loved one. Did you hear that? That's two MSA 30Xs for just $29.95. The MSA 30X Hear Better Now offer. Get two for just $29.95.
All I can say is just try it. It could change your life.
To order the MSA 30X sound amplifier, call 1-800-535-0654. That's 1-800-535-0654. Or you can go to msa30x.com. Call or go online now.
Well, sadly, at least 2 million children live in orphanages around the world.
In some countries like Cambodia and Thailand, many of these orphans have a parent or extended family that could care for them.
As Heather Sells explains in tonight's Focus Report, all they need is a little bit of help.
More than 500 orphanages dot the northern Thailand countryside in the Chiang Mai province. That's a huge number for this region of 1.5 million people. And child advocates say it's a tragedy. Thousands of kids growing up without a parent, separated from their culture. Many orphanages are loving places, like Agape Home, which serves kids who have or may have HIV or AIDS. But even founder Avis Rideout is quick to admit the situation is far from ideal.
This is a great place, you can see it, right? It's a home, but it's not a home. It's a family, but it's not a family. And if I had a choice today, I would not bring in anybody.
Tim Daniel manages Orphans Promise in Asia and says it's heartbreaking to see kids who have family living in institutions.
In orphanages in Thailand especially, you'll find many children who do have one or both parents.
Families in communities like this often find orphanages to be a big temptation, especially if they're raising a sister's child or a daughter's child. That's because the orphanage will care for a child at no cost, and life here is often very hard.
If an orphanage offers to provide free care, free shelter, free food, free clothing, free education, that's going to really help to alleviate the financial pressures on the family.
Government officials like Khun Rasakhan say orphanages should be a last resort for Thai families. And she's especially concerned that many operations tolerate abuse, especially those not registered with the government.
So the places that don't register, you don't know what's going on there.
No.
In recent years, UNICEF and USAID have documented what happens to kids who grow up in institutions. They found delays in mental and physical development, children more at risk for health problems and abuse, and who struggle as adults to re-enter society. Bottom line, kids suffer when they don't have an adult who loves and cares for them permanently.
The caregivers there are sometimes there for short periods of time. They come and they go. They're there because they're being paid to be there. They may love the children, but they're paid to be there.
Such concerns have led Daniel and some others in the international community to begin advocating for what's called family-based or community-based care. In Thailand, it looks like this. 10-year-old Pha lives with her grandma and grandpa. She could have easily ended up in an orphanage because her father is in prison and her mother left the family. As her grandparents financially struggled, they discovered the Orphans Promise program called Keeping Families Together, or KFT. They received parental training, support, and encouragement through what are called family fun days. And they received financial help with a simple investment. Orphans Promise bought the family a bigger wok, allowing Fa's grandma to double her business selling pork on the streets. A new roof also ensures she's protected from monsoon rains while she cooks.
For us, that's a great example. We want them to be an example to their community as well. That, hey, you know what it is? It is possible to keep orphans and vulnerable children in a safe, loving, happy family, but perhaps they just need a little bit of a step up, a little bit of support.
At Agape Home, Avis Rideout is also helping families who want to keep their HIV children.
We are paying for their school fees. We pay for their uniforms, their lunches if they're poor.
It's a no-brainer for Rideout, who says all her children would prefer to be with family.
If you had to ask every one of my kids today, where would they rather be? In the village with a relative or with somebody out of here as a foster child off the ground or here. They would choose to be in the Thai culture.
It's also less costly to support these families than to put children in orphanages. And advocates of family-based care believe these kids will grow up much more secure and with a better chance of finding their way in life as adults. Reporting in Chiang Mai, Thailand, Heather Sells, CBN News.
Up next, find out which big-name chain is now offering to match any discount or online price.
CBNNews.com. News you want, when you want, 24/7. Stay current with up-to-the-minute stories.
Ephraim Graham, CBN News, New York.
I don't have to wait for my news anymore.
CBNNews.com, at your fingertips all day long.
I only watch the stories I want to see.
I find the story, I click on it, and boom, I'm there.
Embassy in Washington, Eric Stackelbeck, CBN News.
The source for your news, CBNNews.com.
My feet hurt.
My feet hurt, your feet hurt. White hot pain, I wanna cry. Is there anything I can try?
Why, yes. Introducing Strut Soul Angels, the human shock absorber that helps alleviate foot pain.
The first 10 steps in the morning to the bathroom were excruciating. Within 3 days after I put Struts on, it's been such a relief.
Slipped it on and almost immediately I felt a support, kind of like a pillow underneath my arches.
The Struts Soul Angel provides a great amount of relief and support throughout the course of the day, providing shock absorption and relief of pain.
On your feet without proper support can be painful. Struts Soul Angels promotes better balance, control, and body alignment. Standing in your heels all day is painful, but slip on Struts and you'll enjoy comfort and support 24/7. Struts is so versatile, you'll wear them in every shoe you own, even barefoot.
I'm on my feet all the time. I teach 11 and 12-year-olds. The pain was so much that I knew I had to do something. And with the Struts, I can do my job and enjoy my job.
I usually am on my feet from 8 to 12 hours a day. When I wear my Struts, it's like giving my feet a hug all day.
It's life-changing. I wear them from the minute I get up to the minute I go to bed.
Why pay $400 for custom orthotics?
Now get Strut Soul Angels for just $10. You also get Miracle Foot Repair Cream, absolutely free. Use it to help relieve dry, callous feet overnight. But wait, call right now and we'll double the offer free. Just pay separate processing and handling. Plus, you get a 100% money-back guarantee. If not completely delighted, send it back, but keep the foot cream as our gift just for trying. You get it all, a $70 value for just $10.
Oh, yes!
Love my Struts, the best thing since sliced bread. The heel pain from toes to head. Get yours now, your doctor said.
Struts, be nice to your feet. Call now.
Call 1-800-787-1580 and get your Struts and Miracle Foot Repair for just $10 and we'll double the offer. That's 1-800-787-1580 or visit getstruts.com.
We have good news tonight for those of you who like to shop.
Yeah, one retail store is offering to match any discounted price on any of the items they sell. Now shoppers won't have to turn to the internet to get the best prices on the hottest items. Target is now on to those customers who window shop at their store and then find a better deal at Amazon.com. They're now matching cheap online prices from Amazon, Best Buy, Toys R Us, and Walmart.com.
I'd be happy to match that for you.
We love it. We love the competition.
The new policy means that everything you see now has potentially two prices, the one listed and the one they'll match, depending on the item. Shoppers now have the potential to save hundreds of dollars on their next trip. And Mark, that's pretty amazing because Amazon is pretty traditionally lower than almost anywhere else.
Oh, yeah. It'll be interesting to see if people actually go online and find that lower price.
Yeah.
That's all for this edition of NewsWatch.
Remember, you can always watch us every night. We'll be here. See you then. Bye-bye.